discussing the continuation topic in the atomic structure, that is atomic stability in the quantum physics. So in this one we are discussing that Bohr's atomic model. In the previous model we discussed the three atomic models, that is the Thomson model and Rutherford model. Today we are discussing on the Bohr's atomic model. See, in the Bohr's atomic model, the Bohr is taken that two atomic postulates which is given by the Rutherford. The first postulate is nothing but, what is given by the Rutherford is the first postulate is nothing but maximum amount of the positive charges which is centered at the center of the atom, that is named as the nucleus. It is named as the nucleus. The first postulate is directly taken by the Rutherford atomic model. Directly the Bohr also taken the same postulate, same point is taken in the Bohr also. That is, the maximum amount of the positive charges is located at the center of the atom. That point is named as the nucleus of the atom. The second postulate is nothing but when the electrons are revolving around the circular orbits, the second postulate is taken from the Bohr's model. The positive charge, the electrons are revolving in the circular orbits around the nucleus. That circular orbits, the positive charge, say when the electrons are revolving in the circular orbits, the outward centripetal force is balanced the inwards electrostatic force. The two are balanced to each other. Electrons are revolving in a circular manner. These two postulates are directly taken by the Bohr from the Rutherford model. Then third point, the Bohr is given that one. See, the electrons will not revolve in all circular orbits. It will exist only particular circular orbits. This is the third one, is very very important. See, the circular orbits can be revolved. It is not in all circular orbit. Only it will revolve in a particular circular orbit. Particular circular orbits. That orbits means where the angular momentum of the circular orbit will directly equal to the, say that nh by 2 pi value. These orbits only the electrons will revolve. Other than this value, the electron will not be revolved in that circular orbit. That means if you take the circular orbit, these are the circular orbits. Let's assume this is the first circle. These circular orbits mean the angular momentum for the circular orbit. So in the first orbit, the n value will become to n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Where is the n is equal to 1, it is the first circular orbit. Where n is equal to 2, it is the second circular orbit. Where n is equal to 3, it is the third circular orbit. See, third point is very very important. What is telling that the electron will not revolve in all circular orbits. It will revolve only in a particular circular orbit where the angular momentum of the circular orbit is directly equal to the nh by 2 pi, where n is the number, n is the integer number, h by 2 pi, h value is the Planck constant, 2 pi is the constant, where n will tell that first n is the first orbit, circular orbit angular momentum must be equal to this value, second orbit, number 2 will tell the second orbit, 3 is the third orbit. See the third point, if you go to the fourth point, see this particular orbit name it as the, see it is the stationary orbits. Very very important, this word is introduced by the Bohr. See, where the electrons are existing in a particular orbit, that particular orbit is named as the stationary orbits. See, now the fourth point is telling that when electron is revolving in a particular stationary orbit, then the electron will not radiate any energy. This is the fourth point. If the electron revolve in a stationary orbit, then it won't radiate. It does not radiate. Any energy. See, that is very very important. See, if the electron is revolving in a particularly stationary orbit, then that electron will not radiate any energy. But you will get the doubt here.
Then if we capture the atomic structure of the any odd element, then we will get the any peaks that where the electrons are, where the electrons are getting in this one. Now we will go to the another point. See, the fifth point is telling that, the fifth point I am writing here. See, the fifth point is telling that if the electron well jumps from upper level to higher energy level to lower energy level, that means the circular orbits. Now I am taking the positive charge of the nucleus. The electrons is leaving first orbit. It is taking the second orbit. If we go to the third orbit, see, according to the first orbit value is equal to first orbit energy value is equal to n h by 2 pi, n value is equal to 1 h by 2 pi. The second orbit value is equal to 2 h by 2 pi. The third value is equal to 3 h by 2 pi. These are the energy value is increasing, slowly increasing. See that when electron is jump from higher energy level to lower energy level, then the electron will radiate the suitable energy which is having energy gap between the two energy level. These are the energy levels of the orbit. These are the orbits of the electron revolving orbits. These also it is named as the energy levels of the electron. If the electron will jumps from higher energy level to lower energy, now I am taking the third orbit. If I am an electron, let's assume take it, the energy of the electron is E3, energy of the second orbit E2, energy of the first orbit is A1. Now if electron jumps from higher energy, now I am taking En plus 1 to, it is jumping to En energy level, then the suitable energy will radiate by the electron. How much energy will radiate? That means N plus 1 minus En into h by 2 pi. For your clear understand, I am taking that one. If the electron jump from the third orbit to second orbit, the energy gap between this one, the energy different, how much is available, that much energy will radiate by the electron from the atom. Then first, say third orbit value is equal to 3 h by 2 pi minus second orbit energy value is equal to 2 h by 2 pi. Now how much value? 3 minus 2 is equal to h by 2 pi value. This much energy will radiate when the electron will jumps. So this is the very very important one. We are recalling one by one. First of all, these 5 points are given by the Rutherford. These 5 points were given by the Bohrs. What are the first point and first and second point is directly taken by the Rutherford atomic model. First one, total positive charges is concentrated at the center of the atom, that is named as the nucleus. The second point is named that when the electron is revolving, the outer pulling force will, the centripetal force is acting outward direction, then the towards force will, which is acting electrostatic force will, these two will balance to each other. So the third one, the electron, only the particular circular orbits only electron will revolve. That particular orbits is named as the stationary orbit. What is the condition of the particular orbit? Means the angular momentum of the particular orbit, it must be equal to nh by 2 pi. Where n is equal to the orbital number. If it is the n is equal to 1, first orbit, the n is equal to 2, second orbit, n is equal to 3, third orbit. The fourth point it is telling, if the electron is revolving in a stationary orbit, it won't radiate any energy from the electron. So then how much long time the electron is revolving in this stationary orbit, it won't radiate any energy. If you go to the fifth point in this one, I already written here. So the fifth point is telling that if the electron will radiate the energy, when if the electron will come out from higher energy orbit to lower energy orbit. I am taking general example here. Only three orbits I took: first orbit, second orbit, third orbit. I am taking the general condition here. If the orbit is jumping from n plus 1 orbit energy level to n orbit, then the how much energy will come? N plus 1 minus n into h by 2 pi energy level will radiate. So I am taking one example, third orbit to electron is jumping from third to second, then E energy of the third orbit minus energy of the second orbit is equal to energy of the third orbit according to Rutherford, n h by 2 pi, where n is equal to third orbit 3 h by 2 pi minus energy of the second orbit 2 h by 2 pi. If it 3 minus 2, if it is h by 2 pi, energy will radiate from this
or electron. These are the most important points which is given by the atomic model, which is given by the Bohr's atomic theory. We will discuss continued topic upcoming classes.